Hey there, I'm Jess Altieri, and today in the Wine Judges Corner, I'm joined by the legend, Dick Peterson. Great to see you. Cheers.
Thank you. Great to be here.
I feel so fortunate. I've gotten a chance to judge with you for the past 2 years now,
yes,
Pacific Rim competition.
Yes.
Tell me, how long have you been judging, and how did you get into it?
I started in the wine business in 1958, and by about 62 or 63, I judged for the state fair and have been doing it ever since, and for a lot of other judgings.
And what do you love about this competition?
Oh, Galliano, the head guy, it's hard to not love him. It's just a fun judging. Everything we do is fun at this judging.
But, and in case people don't know about you, you're a legend. Can you just sort of tell us, you know, how you got into the wine world? You've been all over, and I know you have some exciting news.
Yeah, I was a home winemaker 10 years earlier from freshman in college. Can't count that, I guess. I was only 17. and then I took food science in school. Got my PhD in 1958 and had three job interviews and three offers. One was a brewery, one was Pillsbury frozen foods, refrigerated foods. I would have been making new biscuits and things for them. And the third was Gallo, and I just naturally went to Gallo.
And you have your book that just came out. Congratulations.
Yes. Over the 50 some years that I've been a professional winemaker, I started noticing really odd things and funny things going on in the wine business. Things that people, even good wine drinkers, don't know about. And I started keeping notes, and I built boxes and boxes of notes. Finally sorted them out and put it together into a book form, and it's quite successful. It's really taken off.
And the cover of your book with the barrels, you just have to tell that story.
The barrels was handling wine barrels at Gallo. I was there 10 years, 58 to 68. We didn't use wine in barrels because it was too expensive to do. And I went to then BV in Napa Valley, and they used barrels, but the barrels were built in big 4x4 wooden stacks. And it was very difficult to handle them, to reach in and get a sample and all that. And I fought that for the 6 years I was there, and then another year down at Monterey, knowing that I had to come up somehow with a palette so that it would become easier to handle.
Right.
And finally did that in 1974, the design, and then in 1975, the first use was in Monterey. Other wineries started seeing it, and it just caught hold. And so I gave the design to the industry with a presentation in Fresno in 1975.
Well, we're thankful for that. And it's an honor to meet with you right now and judge with you. And I look forward to this afternoon as well.
Cheers. Thank you. I look forward as well.
Cheers.